A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 9th July, on the front page you have Congress JDS ministers resign, reshuffle likely. So this was front page news yesterday too. The crisis in Karnataka, the Congress JDS Janata Dal Secular coalition government, which is in power in Karnataka, it is facing a crisis because of ministers resigning now, members resigning now. So MLAs are resigning. So because of these resignations, it would lose its majority in the assembly, and BJP is neck to neck. So it may, if these members switch over to BJP, then BJP would be in majority. So this is now, you can see speakers to decide on Karnataka MLA's resignation today. So what BJP is expecting is these MLAs would resign and there would be by-elections in Karnataka and it would win the by-elections. Then here you can see 29 dead, 23 injured as bus falls off Yamuna Expressway. So this is a disaster again, an accident which has struck. The driver is the bus hit the divider and plunged 40 feet down into drain on way to Delhi. Then below you have stock dives as investors fret over tax proposals. So this is because of tax proposals, like you can see the budget proposals are there of higher surcharge, which is expected. Already there is an increased tax surcharge proposed for high income group, and tax on buyback by listed companies, and higher surcharge is going to affect the foreign portfolio investors who operate through trust or an association of persons structure. Then this is CISF Jawan tagged D-voter in Assam. So in Assam, the NRC updation exercise is taking place, the National Register of Citizens updation. And one Jawan, CIF, Central Industrial Security Force Jawan, has been served notice as a D-voter, doubtful voter. So this is less than 2 months after the retired soldier was declared a foreigner, the famous case of Muhammad Sanaullah. So he was a retired soldier and now a CISF Jawan has been called a D-voter in Assam. On page 7 you have no major deficiencies in 1352 dams inspected, says report. So this is the latest report of dam safety that has stated that there are 297 dams in Maharashtra with rectifiable deficiencies which need immediate attention, and another 1055 have minor issues. So these dams have been inspected in Maharashtra, and it says that none of the dams in Maharashtra have any major deficiencies which could lead to failure. Then on page 9 you have Supreme Court asks why delay in setting up right courts. So the Supreme Court has sought a response from the center, states and union territories on prolonged delay for over a quarter of a decade to establish exclusive human rights courts in each district and appointing special public prosecutors to them. So the Human Rights Act has called for establishment of such special courts in each district for speedy trial of human rights offences. It's section 30 of the Act which provides for this, but these courts have still not been set up. So this is the Act of 1992-93. So since then, still we don't have the courts being set up. And here you have Supreme Court dismisses plea to allow women to enter mosques. So there was a petition filed by the president of Kerala unit of Akhil Bharatiya Hindu Mahasabha to allow Muslim women to enter mosques for offering prayer and to shed the parda system. But the Supreme Court has dismissed this petition and says let a Muslim woman challenge this. And this is National Repository of Photographs mooted. So the central government wants to create a repository of photographs of criminals in the country, and it wants to put a system in place also to track missing children and unidentified dead bodies through facial recognition. So the National Crime Records Bureau has invited bids for automated facial recognition system. So it should be able to even capture face images from CCTV feed and generate alerts if a blacklist match is found. On the editorial page, the first editorial is The Visible Hand. So this talks about this crisis in Karnataka. It says BJP must not stake claim to form a ministry in Karnataka without an absolute majority. And here you have a regrettable conviction. So this is regarding Mr. Vaiko, who has been found guilty of sedition. So it says this strengthens the case to scrap section 124A of IPC. So this is a prominent pro-LTT politician, Vaiko, who has been charged of sedition based on a speech he made in Chennai a decade ago. Then the lead article is reinforcing caste hierarchies. So it says the Maratha quota is a case in point of what a progressive Indian polity should not be doing, because Marathas are not backward, but they have been given the status of backward community and been given reservation. The Maharashtra government has given them reservation as economically weaker section. So they have created a new category because they will not come under backward castes. So economically weaker section is a new category created, and it is only Marathas who are there who are economically weaker. So even the Bombay High Court has upheld this reservation. Then this is a shot at economic logic. So it says India needs to anticipate the promising impact of the African continentally free trade area. So there's a FTA, African continental FTA. So what would be the consequences of this FTA is to be understood by India as well. So African Union concluded this on 8th July. That is, it had an extraordinary summit which was held specifically for this. So 54 of the 55 member states signed this African Continental Free Trade Agreement for goods and services. So this is going to have its impact. So that has to be understood. You can see here, it says that this will be world's largest FTA, and in a world dependent on African markets and commodities, it would have global impact. Then on op-ed page, we have the importance of democratic education. So this article says how understanding democracy is important. Otherwise, we'll continue to allow unhealthy skepticism about democracy to grow. So this is a concern too, that people should understand the importance of democracy. Otherwise, unhealthy skepticism is going to have adverse consequences. Then this is a myopic view of foreign-made generic drugs. So it says US is using Ranbaxy experience to create a bogey. So allegations of widespread fraud concerning generic drugs manufactured overseas, especially in India, were recently highlighted in the USA. So much focus is on the contamination found in one drug made by Ranbaxy. So this is now about how generic drugs manufactured in India are being opposed in USA. So of course it will have consequences for the patients who would be getting cheap drugs. So quality concern is being raised, and you know how generics are being deprived, people have been deprived of generics. Then this is towards a free trade agreement. So it says India and US should aim to progressively eliminate trade and investment barriers. So this is regarding India-US economic relations. Then on page 12 you have Congress opposes Jallianwala Bagh bill. So Congress has opposed the introduction of this Jallianwala Bagh National Memorial Amendment bill in Lok Sabha because it seeks to remove the Congress president as a permanent member of the trust that runs the Jallianwala Bagh National Memorial. And then below you have UAPA bill draconian, not based on logic. So this is regarding National Investigation Agency Amendment Bill, which has been introduced, and the Unlawful Activities Prevention Amendment Bill. Both have been introduced in the Lok Sabha amid protests by opposition. So you should know about NIA, National Investigation Agency. It was set up in 2009 in the wake of the Mumbai terror attacks. So then the NIA bill has been amended and it has been criticized. It says, opposition says that NIA is not insulated from political interference. And you can see it's what the bill seeks to do is seeks to strengthen the agency by giving it powers to investigate terror attacks targeting Indians and Indian interests abroad. And UAPA bill, Unlawful Activities Prevention Bill, seeks to allow an individual suspected to have terror links to be designated a terrorist as such. So this term has been called draconian by the opposition. Someone who is suspected of terror links, not proved, will be declared a terrorist. Then you have Rajya Sabha too clears Aadhaar bill. So the Aadhaar amendment bill has been passed by Rajya Sabha as well. Then on page 13 you have UN report legitimizes terror, says India. So the UN Commission on Human Rights has said that India and Pakistan have failed to improve the situation in Kashmir and not taken any concrete steps to address the numerous concerns raised in the earlier report. So this report talks of both India and Pakistan. So on this, India responds that the report legitimizes terror, Pakistan-sponsored terror, and but the report says about both the nations, they have not done enough to resolve the Kashmir situation. And this is Orisha plans scheme for witness protection. So security will be based on threat perception. And this is the front page news regarding CISF Jawan tagged doubtful voter. Then on international page you have conservative leader Mitsotakis take oath as Greece PM. So Greece has a conservative leader in power now. So this is regarding that. And this is Iran makes new threats that would reverse steps in nuclear deal. So Iran has threatened yesterday to restart deactivated centrifuges and ramp up investment of uranium to 20% purity as its next potential big moves away from the 2015 nuclear agreement. So if these steps are taken, then it would reverse all the steps which have been achieved, progress which has been achieved through the Iran nuclear deal. So it wants to renegotiate the deal and have safeguards against US sanctions. Otherwise, it says it's going to renege the nuclear agreement step by step. Then you have court begins hearing on Italian Marines case. So this is an international arbitration court which is hearing into Italy's request to direct India to drop all criminal prosecution against two Italian Marines accused of killing two Indian fishermen off the Kerala coast in 2012 and grant Rome jurisdiction in the case. So this was a case prominently in news in 2012 when two Italian Marines, they killed two Indian fishermen, suspecting them to be, pirates as such. But then this happened in the, it has been claimed that this happened in international waters, but India insists that the accused shot should return to New Delhi for final judgment by an Indian court. So these two Marines presently are in Delhi. They were arrested by India, but then they were released because of tension in the relations. You can see they have been sent back to Italy. An international arbitration court is hearing this case in The Hague. Then on business page you have FPIs press the panic button on tax surcharge. So the government has targeted high income individuals when they have proposed a tax surcharge, but this has taken a toll on foreign investors in the Indian capital market. So foreign portfolio investors in India, they operate through a trust or limited liability partnership structure, and now they are not recognized as corporate entities by Indian Income Tax Act as such. So they will be taxed as per the individual tax slabs based on their earnings. So they are also going to face these high taxations and surcharges. So that has become a cause of concern, and you can see how stocks also crashed. So this is one major reason. Then below you have RBI board finalizes Utkarsh 2022. So this is a 3-year roadmap to improve regulation and supervision. So RBI board has finalized this roadmap. So it's on regulation and supervision and other functions of the central bank. So it's a medium term statement that has been called Utkarsh 2022, in line with the global central bank's plan to strengthen the regulatory and supervisory mechanism. Then this is spectrum auction. So TRAI sticks to its position. Telecom Regulatory Authority of India has stuck to its earlier recommendation on the forthcoming spectrum auction, so including the base price and valuation of spectrum to be put on sale. So there were concerns raised on high 5G prices, but TRAI sticks to its position. On page 16 you have SEBI gets teeth to probe new age cases. So now SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, can fine up to 10 crore rupees if a person tampers with information to obstruct investigation or destroy data. So such new powers have been given to SEBI through the Finance Bill 2019. So you should know Allocation Bill and Finance Bill are two parts in which budget is passed. So the Finance Bill 2019 has this provision. So there are financial bills and money bills that are different, that are generally passed, but this is regarding the Finance Bill, which is part of the budget. And on the last page you have British Airways faces record $230 million fine for data breach. So about 5 lakh customers lost their personal data to hackers. So that's why British Airways has to pay this fine for the data breach, which is the largest penalty against a company for privacy lapses under the new European data protection law. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.